baby, let me see it. Jalebi baby, I just wanna eat it. Jalebi Baby sensation. So she really doesn't need any introduction as such because all the Bollywood fans know her. But still, for the unknown, I'll introduce her. She is an Indo-Canadian vocalist. She's an award-winning singer. She has worked with Ayushmann Khurrana in the movie Hawaizaada. She has shared the stage with the music maestro Salim-Sulaiman for the IIFA Awards, and she has shared the stage in none other than Indian Prime Minister PM Modi and the Canadian Prime Minister and sung the Indian National Anthem. How proud is that? I mean, it's a great feeling for us Indians. And now she is doing cover songs of many iconic songs, and she is on to win your hearts. So let's welcome her and let's get to know her more. So here is your very own Shweta Subram.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here, Sir. Thanks for having me today.
Yeah, it's a pleasure to meet you, Shweta.
Thank you.
So let's start. So Shweta, you are a famous Indo-Canadian singer, songwriter and performer. Tell us more about yourself and your background.
Yeah, sure. So where do I begin? growing up, I'm the only child. My parents and I were living in Dubai. And so Dubai holds a very special place in my heart. So I was here, and being the only child, my parents were really ambitious. They really wanted me to be an all-rounder, so could be do singing, very good dancing, as well as like go to school and keeping up with my studies. There was a lot going on. And then somewhere I think my passion for music took over. I remember just doing it as a hobby. I was participating in cultural programs, associations in Dubai that had different events. So I would participate and just perform and I would bring a lot of laurels. I used to run a lot of laurels competitions. And then basically, that's where I started thinking, maybe I could take music a little bit more seriously. I went to Canada, I participated in the North American singing talent hunt. It was a 4-month-long competition in Indo-Canadian. And I won that, and like as they say, the rest is history.
Wow.
That's how my journey went.
That's great to know. So you have performed at the IIFA with the legendary musician Salim-Sulaiman.
Yes.
So how was your experience sharing the stage with him?
Oh, it was amazing. It was such an ecstatic moment for me. Because I remember when Salim-Sulaiman's team reached out to me, the way they found out about them was because I had put two songs, my only compositions, songs that I had written on YouTube.
Okay.
One was called Jimmy and the other was called Chupa.
Okay.
Honestly, I did it for fun. I remember in 2010, I was going through this phase where I wanted to write my own songs and compose my own songs. So I put it out and this one, Salim-Sulaiman's team, caught their eye. And they decided to reach out to me and ask me to perform at the IIFA Awards, and it was a music launch for a film called Hazan. So I performed a song, Khuda Ke, at the IIFA Awards, and it was such award-winning moment for me because I remember Shah Rukh Khan, Karan Johar,
Dhamma,
and a lot of the audience was just watching me. So just to have the whole film fraternity, witness my performance, it was such a great moment.
Wow, that's great to know. So you have such a unique voice which really breathes life into any, song. So who is your inspiration?
Thank you very much for that compliment. I get that a lot from people that they say I have a very unique tone of quality, unique voice, very husky voice.
Yeah.
And I feel very blessed about that. Inspiration I get from so many different people and different legendary singers. You know, growing up, I was listening to Asha Ji, Lata Mangeshkar Ji, I think we all learn so much from them. They are such an institution themselves. So I believe that the first and foremost thing is to actually believe that you're still a student.
Right.
No matter how much success you accomplish, if you think you know it all,
yeah.
that's I think that's where and so it's very important to learn from some accomplished musicians and indie singers. So I believe that I get my inspiration from so many different artists every single day. So keep your ears open and listen to good music.
Yeah, the idea is to keep learning and keep growing.
Yeah,
exactly. Yes, all your life. So, Jalebi Baby, the most trending song on TikTok, is like loved by pretty much everyone. So, how did you feel singing such a catchy song, and how life been post Jalebi Baby's success?
Yeah, it was fabulous because I remember, I was introduced to this artist, actually, by a friend of mine. He's a fellow Canadian, and I'm a Canadian as well.
Yeah.
He was based in Toronto, and I didn't know about Tishore, actually, prior to Jalebi Baby. So when a friend told me about him, I sent him a message congratulating him for his works. And I think the timing was right, because he was looking for a female vocalist for Jalebi Baby. And I remember him telling me that, listen, how about we record something? I'm going to send you the track, and thanks to technology, because all this happened during lockdown.
Okay.
All this happened during COVID.
Okay.
So I remember getting this track on my email.
So you recorded it here
at home in Dubai. So basically, I had my setup at home, my microphone, my software, everything put together. I recorded my vocals. Honestly, it took me like 30 minutes. I did that, I sent it across to him with no expectations at all. And then, track was released. It's going viral, it's going to
the zone. Now it's in the buzz.
It's amazing, people are doing so many different dance covers.
Right.
Different videos on TikTok. And
just taking the internet.
By storm.
Yeah.
It has. It's great like for all the love and admiration I'm getting. People are so inviting to me and, with the entire song, maybe it's just like one line. It's
right.
But it is an important part of the song.
Right.
It's song. So it's very overwhelming and very, it's great to hear people say that that line makes the song.
And you know that Jalebi, it's got attached to it.
I don't need Jalebi, but it's nice to be known as Jalebi.
Yeah.
So why does it bring?
Yeah, okay. So what changes you have seen in music industry over the years, and especially at a platform like YouTube?
Yeah, so I find that social media in general has grown so much in the past few years because of social media, because of YouTube, not just YouTube, even because of apps like Instagram and Facebook. So many artists are able to expose themselves. In fact, YouTube worked like a resume for social media. I remember when YouTube first came out.
And you have 20 million views on YouTube.
That's
not a small feat.
It's no small feat, but thanks to all the people that decided to work with me and collaborate with me, everything's teamwork. And that's what technology is all about. It's a blessing to have platforms like YouTube because you can reach out to other artists across the globe. You don't have to be in the same geography. And basically, you have to be open to working with musicians from across the globe. Thank God, blessings that we're living in an age where.
And thanks to technology, the whole world is coming together.
Yeah, we have access to all these apps and platforms.
Yeah.
So it's really a blessing. And I tell all the artists out there, use YouTube to your complete advantage.
Yeah.
Create songs, compose songs, work with other artists, and put out music that you never know from this thing.
Right.
In fact, from what I know, AI technology still goes to YouTube to discover artists.
Wow.
So don't take it for granted.
Keep going, all the aspiring singers. So Shweta, for our viewers in our Dubai and worldwide, we would like to hear a song from you. So please tune some lines.
Sure, it's a good one.
Thank you. for a good song. So let's have the very trending, the very popular Jalebi Baby song. Shweta.
Okay, so I think a few lines of the song is just one line in that.
Okay. And just wanna get crazy, crazy, shanty, slowly, chippy, chippy.
Let me see it. Jalebi, baby. I just wanna eat it. Jalebi.